Hey everybody, so I've had a number of requests to do a baby food, finger food ideas video. Just things that I feed my 10-month-old Cassidy, things I've been feeding her in the past and that I will continue to feed her that are easy for her to eat and kind of mash up and swallow. I did do a couple finger food recipe idea videos back in the day, probably 5 or 6 years ago on this channel, so if I can remember, I will link down certain recipes that kind of take these ideas a little bit farther. A lot of these are basic foods that don't really require a recipe, they're just the foods that they are whole. But for those of you who have kids in the same age range as Cassidy, give or take a couple months, maybe 6 months on either end, I thought you guys would find this helpful. And feel free to leave your ideas down in the comments below so people can see what you're feeding your kids as well and what works well. Now to start off with, Cassidy, we did a combination when she turned 6 months old of baby led weaning and purees. We didn't stick to one or the other. We started with like whole avocado and moved on to sweet potato. We also did purees and things like that. But probably by the time she was eight and a half months old, she's really not into being spoon fed or eating purees for the most part. I can still get away with the squeezy packs when we're on the go, but she really likes to eat table food. So she's now 10 months old and she pretty much just eats table food for the majority of meals unless we're on the go. So I made a list here in front of me of some ideas, but before I start, I of course just want to preface this by saying every baby is different and every parent's comfort level is different. So you may be interested in some of these and you might not be comfortable with some of these and your baby might be ready or might not be ready, and that's okay. This is just a video of ideas and things that I'm feeding my 10-month-old. All right, first one is scrambled eggs. This one is awesome because it's super quick to make and babies generally like the taste of it. And it's one of those foods that you can break up really, really small, but even in their mouth, it kind of just dissolves. So those are really good ones to start with. Also, little pieces of bread or toast, similar to like puffs that you can buy in the store. You're able to break it really small. And if it's in baby's mouth and they don't have teeth yet, a lot of these foods she was eating when she doesn't have teeth, she currently has two on the bottom, but I mean, they don't really help her with the mashing. It's the gums that are doing the majority of the work. So things that dissolve quickly and are soft. So eggs and bread. Cheese, she really loves cheese, and I find if I just shred up some cheese, she can pick it up that way. And again, I'm not worried about her getting too much in her mouth because they're just tiny shreds of cheese. So I think that's a good one. My baby, for some reason, she loves food, first of all, but she loves to pack in as much as she can. So I used to give her like whole bananas and whole avocados and things like that that I used to do for my previous two kids where I did more baby-led weaning, and they did fine with that. They would just kind of break off chunks and hold on to it. And this is where I say every baby is different. Cassidy is not like that. If she gets a whole banana in her hand, she will continue to push the banana back into her mouth until she starts coughing on it. I'm not really worried about her choking per se, but it's just not a comfortable situation when she keeps packing it all in. So that's why I like to go with the smaller bits of things. But like I say, every baby is different. And then staying on that trend, soft fruits. So things like the banana, the avocado, things you can break up in small chunks or just give them a whole stick if they're comfortable with that. Berries are a great one because you can give them the whole berry if it's really small and mushy, or you can just chop it up. Even soft vegetables. So if you really overcook things, you can get them quite soft, like carrots. Even cauliflower and broccoli, we've done green beans, peas, we'll just kind of smush them. Well, she's getting to that point now where she can just eat the peas as they are. What other vegetables have we done? Asparagus, she loves asparagus. Obviously, I just overcook it and I make it quite soft. But really any vegetable, if you just make sure that you cook it enough so that it's not still really hard and crunchy, it should be fine for a baby in that age range. All right, so as far as meat, the things I have found are the easiest for her to eat are things that are shredded. So shredded chicken, shredded pork, you can just do it with a fork. So they're kind of stringy, long pieces like so, or just cut up the shreds once you actually shred it. And then for beef, ground beef. She's been fine with ground beef for a long time. We can mix it with some rice, so there's a little bit more grains in there as well. Or I just give her rice on her own. She really likes brown rice. Pasta. I have never met a baby that doesn't like pasta. So in the beginning, when you're still worried about them getting the idea of chewing, you can like really overcook the pasta and then rip it into tiny little pieces. But as they get better at it, you don't have to overcook it so much. You can give them the whole pasta. It depends on the different shapes that you want to give them, but babies love pasta. Another idea, if you're not so much into the meat side of things, is tofu. We make a lot of stir fries in our house that often include tofu. And tofu is so easy for a baby to eat because it just mushes away in their mouth and it just tastes like whatever it is you seasoned it with, or it can taste like nothing. They even make like dessert ones, although I don't know what the additives in that would be. But tofu is a good one, really safe and easy to start off with. And then the last thing that she really likes are potatoes. So mashed potatoes are a great one because, again, you can just take handfuls of mashed potatoes and shove it in their mouth. A lot of these things create a big mess, so be aware of that. It's a baby though. They're gonna love exploring different textures and tastes and making that big mess, and I just know that going into it, and have great bibs and be ready to clean up. But the other thing is hash browns. Cassidy loves hash browns, so that's just another idea to use with potatoes. So that was just my quick list of ideas. Obviously there's a ton more you could feed your baby, but people just want to know some things that Cassidy in particular is loving, things that we often feed her. Sometimes we'll just feed these things like as a separate item on their own, but a lot of times a lot of these ingredients are incorporated to our family meals. So a pasta meal, a casserole meal, a like rice chicken kind of meal, and that's just the way I serve it to her. So whether it's shredded or I break it in pieces or I overcook her portion, that's just been how we've been feeding her. So she pretty much eats what we eat for the most part. If it's something, I'm trying to think, like a really hard vegetable or like steak or something like that, I'm not comfortable giving her that yet. But again, to each their own. This is not a judgmental video. This is just some ideas. I hope you guys found that helpful. Like I said, please leave your ideas in a comment down below in case someone's stumbling across this video and they want more ideas. If you are new to this channel and you are just stumbling across this video, please subscribe. There's a button down below. I upload multiple new videos every week, and I think that's about it. If you have any questions, let me know, and thank you so much for watching. Bye!